forever. That's how long per- and polyfluorinated substances, or PFAS, last. They're synthetic chemicals used in hundreds of industrial and consumer products like cookware, clothing, and cosmetics. Their high-strength carbon-fluorine bonds make PFAS repellent to oil and water, and also extremely resilient to breakdown, so they'll be around long after we're gone. PFAS escape from products and are found in the bodies of 99% of people. They come with a long list of adverse health effects, from immune suppression to cancer. To reduce harm, governments, companies, and researchers have been studying and regulating PFAS one by one. Doing this for the thousands of different kinds of these forever chemicals could take centuries. This is a dangerously inadequate approach. Therefore, 16 scientists from universities, NGOs, and U.S. and EU government agencies came together to assess past scientific research on PFAS. Based on what they found, they are urging businesses and governments to apply a class-based approach to reduce harm from PFAS. We can and must discontinue all non-essential uses of PFAS while developing safer alternatives for current essential uses. This approach is already working. Leading companies like IKEA and Levi Strauss & Co. have phased out PFAS in the textiles they manufacture and sell. San Francisco, Washington, Maine, and the country of Denmark have banned them from paper-based food packaging. Forever is a very long time. All PFAS should be treated as one class and restricted to only those uses that are currently essential.